नमस्कार बच्चों, बैक विद यू ऑल विद द चैप्टर ऑफ प्रोडक्शन फंक्शन। इन दिस चैप्टर टुडे यू आर गोइंग टू लर्न द न्यू टॉपिक दैट इज रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन, यू कैन सी ऑन द स्क्रीन, यू कैन सी ऑन द ब्लैक बोर्ड, व्हाट इज द रिलेशन बिटवीन द टीपी कॉल्ड एज टोटल प्रोडक्ट एंड एमपी कॉल्ड एज मार्जिनल प्रोडक्ट। नाउ स्टूडेंट्स, ऑल ऑफ यू नो इट, इट्स वेरी इजी टू लर्न द डेफिनेशंस, it's very easy to learn the relation between the TP and MP. But if I can teach you how we write the relationship, how we can derive the relationship between the TP and MP with the help of a magical table, then I think automatically you can learn not only for today but for the whole life. That's a technique. That technique I am going to teach you all today. Number one. Second, in the exam, you are getting the numericals also. Again, I'm saying, in the exam, you are getting the numericals also based on the table. Now, question is, how we actually prepare the table? How we prepare the numerical sum? That also I'm going to teach you all today with a simple technique. So, let's come. There are three columns you can see, first, second and third at the behind of me. Let's come. First, in the column of first column, you take only L. L stands for what? L stands for label. You write the label, suppose 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I have just written 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is what L. L means what? Label. In the second column, see, I am going to write a formula. Please write down in your notebook. This is called as TP. Called as total product. What's the formula here? A into P, average product multiplied by L. AP into L. We say what? AP into L, average product multiplied by L. Oblique. There is another formula called as summation of MP, called as marginal product. Again, I'm telling you all, what's the formula? TP is equals to AP into L oblique. That is summation of MP. Okay. Next, after writing the formula of TP, we come to the third column where you're going to find MP called as marginal product equals to delta. Delta means what? Change. Delta TP upon delta, delta means again change, delta L. So what's the formula of marginal product? Delta TP upon delta L. So this is what? This is the formula of marginal product. So in the first column I have taken label, second column I have taken what? TP, and at the last I have taken what? MP. Now again come back at the top, what is the relation between the TP and MP? So you are going to learn how to write the relationship. Well, but so you do one thing. I am going to frame a table. Before framing the table, I am asking you, you just keep in your mind that one value here in the column that is called MP, one value in the third column you have to bring as zero. Again, I am repeating, you have to bring one value as zero. In order to bring one value as zero, what you will do? You have to repeat one value in the column of TP. Again, I am repeating, in order to bring one value as zero in the column of marginal product, you have to repeat the same value in the TP column. See, I am going to teach you how to frame the table. First one I have taken as 50, then 90, then 120, then 140, and I have done what? 140. That's the magic. 140. And again, what I have said? 140. The technique, you have to remember it in your mind. In exam, if you get a table in any way, you just lock in your mind that at least one value will come. At least one value will come in the marginal product, which will represent to what? Zero. And in order to get the value of zero, you have to repeat a value in the what? In the value of what? In the column of TP. Next. After repeating the same value, what happens? You have to bring one value down. Now again you will have a doubt in your mind, sir, why we are bringing the value here down? Because below the zero you are going to get the what? Negative value. So in order to get the value negative in what? In the column of MP. In the column of MP, in order to get the value what? In the negative, we have to bring down one value from where? From the second column of TP. Next, come back, third column, what's the formula of MP? MP is equals to what? Delta TP upon delta L. That is change in total product due to the change in one more unit of output. Let's come back here. Suppose you are having an organization. In your organization, on the very first day, pehla din, bhaiya pehla din ki baat hai. First day, you have appointed only one labor. That labor is able to produce 5050 output. If I ask you, what is behind 50? अरे सर कुछ तो नजर नहीं आ रहा, ऐसे क्वेश्चन पूछ रहे हो. अगेन व्हाट इज बिहाइंड 50? सर नजर नहीं आ रहा. लुक एट, नथिंग इज देयर, स्ट्रेट अवे यू टेक जीरो. डोंट वरी, इफ यू से सर नो जीरो, पुट अ डैश 50 डैश, नथिंग एल्स. व्हाट्स द वैल्यू हियर? 5050. कंपेयर द वैल्यू. नंबर वन. सेकेंड डे इन योर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, अगेन व्हाट यू आर डूइंग, यू आर अपॉइंटिंग टू लेबर. First day you are appointing one labor, second day you are appointing the two labor. 2 minus 1, 1. On the next day, what you are doing? You are increasing one more unit of labor. So if you are increasing the one more unit of labor, see why, what is happening here? 90. That labor is able to produce 90 units of output. Again, if I ask you, what is the difference between the 90 and 50? Your answer would be, sir, 40. Again the same thing follow. Third day you are appointing three labor, so 3 minus 2 1. Again what you are doing, you are adding one more unit of labor. So what is the difference again here? 120, again 90. What is the difference? Same, 30. Again on the fourth day, four labor. 4 minus 3 1. The same calculation you have to do. What I mean to say is that same simple calculation you do it. That means per day you are increasing one unit of labor. So 4 minus 3, 1. 1 labor. Again, when you are increasing, again, what is the difference here? Just see, 140 minus 120. Again, 2020. But on the fifth day, 5 labor. Again, subtract by what? 4, 5 minus 4. Again, you are appointing what? One more unit of labor. So again, just see, 140 and 140. If I ask you, just subtract, what would be the difference? Zero. Just see the magic. So simple. I already told you at the beginning, to get the value of zero, here in what? In the column of MP, you have to repeat the word, one value in the column of TP. So simple. Again, just after zero, piche aana padega. Bhai, negative to aega hi aega. So what we have to do? Bring the value down. In the column what? In the column of TP. So 6 again minus 5. One more labor we are appointing. Again just see the difference. 136 and 140. That means what? You are going to get here minus 4. I think you can see how easily I have drawn the table. Same way what we are doing, we are writing the numericals in the book also. So today I already taught how we are writing or how we are preparing the numericals in the book also. I think you must have understood till now. Next, the topic goes to what? Write the relationship between the TP and MP. Just see. First, I am putting here a sign. I will explain you. Don't take tension. Again, I am putting an arrow from here and I am covering here. And at the last, one more I am doing here. Here I am writing first stage. Okay? This is called first stage. Here I am writing, this is called second stage. And at the last, I am writing, this is the last one, only this one, minus 4. Remember, you know, only this one, last one, minus 4. This is, I am writing here, called as third stage. Third stage. So, bacho, I am going to teach you the relation with the help of a simple example. Look at here. This is my machine. You may be joking, you may be enjoying. Sir, this is a duster. Don't make a joke. Don't worry, this is a duster. Assume it. Like in economics, what we do? We assume many things. So from my view, this is a machine and I am assuming you assuming it as a what? As a machine. So you also assume this is what? A machine. Dekho, in this machine maximum 100 labor can work. Is machine pe 100 labor maximum kaam kar sakte hain. Next, on my first day, not mine, why should I? Aap karo. On the first day, what you have done? You have appointed only 50 labor. How many labor? 50 labor. You know the human nature. Initially, when we get a job, we do very hard work. हम खुद पढ़ते हैं, खुद मेहनत करते हैं, काम करते हैं. That same thing is happening here also. 50 labor. When they got the job, they started doing very hard work. What they have done? They are working very hard. As a result, output will increase. Come back. First relation. When MP increases, TP also increases. Bachcho, one thing you must remember in your mind. MP means additional. Additional will always increase more. Number one. Additional will always decrease more. Number two. Again, I'm repeating. Lock in your mind. MP means additional. Additional will always increase more. And additional will always decrease more. So in the first case, what happened? This 50 labor is working more hard. So MP increases, then TP also increases. But MP will increase more than TP. Number one. First relation. Next. On the machine, what is the maximum capacity of the employees? Or what is the maximum number of labor who can work? 100. How many? 100. On the first day, how many labors you have appointed? 50. Chalo, theek hai. Next day, second day, what you doing? You have started increasing the labor. Pehle din mein 50 the. Next day mein what you have done? 60, 70, 80, 90. Apna India hai, bhaiya. ये तो सबको पता है कि भाई हम क्यों मेहनत करेंगे. आओ नए कर्मचारी आ रहे हैं, बोझ उन पे थोपो, लेट देम वर्क. सो अल्टीमेटली व्हाट विल हैपन? दोस 50 लेबर दे स्टार्ट डूइंग लेस वर्क. एज ए रिजल्ट मार्जिनल प्रोडक्टिविटी विल कम डाउन. कम हियर आफ्टर 50 लुक एट द वैल्यू 40 30 20 एमपी इज फॉलिंग. व्हाट इज द इंपैक्ट ऑन द मार्जिनल प्रोडक्ट? एमपी इज फॉलिंग. व्हेन एमपी फॉल्स टीपी देखो 90 120 140. अरे बाबा टीपी क्या हो रहा है? इट इज इंक्रीजिंग. सेकेंड रिलेशन सेज व्हेन एमपी फॉल्स टीपी इंक्रीजेस बट एट डिमिनिशिंग रेट. स्टूडेंट्स यू मस्ट नो इन योर माइंड दैट इन द बोर्ड एग्जाम दे आर आस्किंग दिस क्वेश्चन इन द ऑब्जेक्टिव टाइप क्वेश्चन. व्हेन एमपी फॉल्स लुक एट द टेबल. व्हेन एमपी फॉल्स एट व्हाट रेट टीपी इंक्रीजेस. आई एम रिपीटिंग द क्वेश्चन. व्हेन एमपी फॉल्स एट व्हाट रेट टीपी इंक्रीजेस. आंसर क्या हुआ? एट डिमिनिशिंग रेट. गॉट इट? दैट्स द रिलेशन नंबर टू. कम बैक अगेन. सेम एग्जांपल. दिस इज माय मशीन, नॉट माय मशीन, योर मशीन. व्हाट इज द मैक्सिमम कैपेसिटी ऑन योर मशीन टू वर्क? हाउ मेनी लेबर्स कैन वर्क? योर आंसर इज 100. फर्स्ट डे हाउ मेनी लेबर्स यू हैव अपॉइंटेड? 50. सेकेंड डे 60, 70, 80, 90. थर्ड डे 100, 110. 100, 110, but capacity is how much? Only 100. What is the maximum capacity? 100. Is machine pe 100 mazdoor se zyada kaam kar hi nahi sakte. How many appointed? How many extra you have appointed? 110. So 10 labors are in extra. 10 labors are in what? Extra. So if I ask you, what is the job of those 10 labor? Your answer would be, sir, golla. Kuch nahi karenge, golla. MP is what? Straight away. See, zero. Got it? Why it is zero? Because that labor is contributing nothing. That labor is doing what? Contributing nothing. So when MP is zero, TP is what? Repeated? This is called maximum. Again, I'm telling third relation. When MP is equals to zero, TP is what? TP is maximum. And again, a stage will come where you have appointed 110 labor. That is 10 labor in extra. Ultimately, after zero, what will happen? Their marginal productivity will be negative. So that's the relation number four. When MP is negative, TP falls. Okay, when MP is negative, TP falls. So now the same table you can see also here I have drawn on the screen. Now bachcho, again you can see the same table on the screen. Okay, the one which I have explained on the blackboard. In the first column, you can see what I have done. Labor applicant 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. In the second column, you can see TP called as total product. Again, remember the same formula AP into L oblique another formula is a, that's called summation of MP. And again in the third column, the same concept, you have to find the marginal product. What's the formula again? That's called delta TP upon delta L. Okay, in the second column, the same values are there. That's called 50, 90, 120, 140 and 140 again. 136, called as 136. And in the third column, 50, first you can see their first stage. After that 40, 30, 20, 0. Second stage. And at the last, you can see minus 4, called as third stage. Okay, now you will see how to write the relationship. First relation, when MP increases, TP also increases. But MP increases more than TP, already I have explained you with the help of the table. Second, when MP falls, TP increases, but at diminishing rate. For your benefit, I have highlighted specially with the blue color. I have highlighted specially for you and also I have underlined it. Again, I'm repeating the same question. When MP falls, what will be the impact on the TP? You must remember, TP increases but at diminishing rate. Third relation, when MP is equals to 0, then TP is what? Maximum. Again, I'm saying when MP goes to 0, TP is maximum. That's relation number 3. And at the last, you can see when MP is negative, then TP falls. So these are the what? 4 relationship between the what? Between the MP and TP. Hope you must have enjoyed the topic. Thanks to all of you.